Good morning, children. How are you? I hope you all are doing good, right? Yes, in the previous class, we have learned about our state. Yes, that is a block 12, our state. We have completed our state. What are the clothes, food, what are the monuments in our state? We have learned everything about our state, that is Telangana. And we have read about some in our country, India, some states also like Kerala, Himachal Pradesh, Maharashtra, Manipur. Yes. What are the food they eat, what the language they speak, everything we have learned in the previous block, that is our states. Now in today's class, we will start our new block, that is local governing bodies. What are the local governing bodies, children? Local governing bodies are the people who solve the problems like in villages, Gram Panchayat, and cities, municipality. In detail, we'll go in the next works. But in today's class, we'll learn about solving problems. Yes, children, I have a small question for you. Whom do you go when you feel hungry? Your mother, your parents, or your neighbors? Whom do you go? We go to our parents, right? Or mother for food, not our neighbors. You'll go, if you feel hungry, you'll go to your neighbors and ask? No, you'll go to your mother or your parents or your grandparents and go and ask them if you feel hungry. Like that only, we have some rights, right people, who are the right people to solve the problems. We have some certain things. Okay, that is our S1 topic, law, solving problems. I have some small questions for you all. That who solved the problems? Like now, if you feel hungry, where you'll go? We have a choice, mother or neighbors. Where you'll go? Mother. Like that only, I have small questions for you all. Let's do it, children. Okay?
Yes, children, this is the some situations, some problems. So who will solve it? We will see, children. Okay, let's read the first one. You are unable to see the board from where you sit, where you are sitting in the class. Whose help will you take? Teacher, principal, parent, neighbor, anyone else? You are unable to see the board from where you are sitting in the class. Whose help you will take? Teacher, principal, parent, neighbor, anyone else? Teacher, right? So, right, correct answer is the teacher. You will take the teacher help. Next, second one. You have fever at home. You want to have something hot. Who will you go to? Whom will you go to? Teacher, principal, parent, neighbor, anyone else? You'll go and you are having fever at home and you want something hot. You'll go to your teacher or principal and ask? No, right? So whom you will ask? Parent. So who will solve your need? Parent. You want to buy a new toy. Who will you ask? Teacher, principal, parent, neighbor, anyone else? Who will you ask for a new toy? Again, parent only. Your teacher need more chairs and tables for the class. Who will she or go? Where she will go? Principal. The wooden chair in your house is broken. Whose help will your parent take? Person who repairs chairs, milkman, postman, driver. Who will repair it? The person who repairs the chairs. The milkman can come and repair the wooden chair, children? No. Only a specific person can do the specific work. Milkman only supplies the milk. And postman gives only the post. And driver will only drive the car. And repairs chairs only will repair the broken chairs. So, specific people can only solve some specific problems. You had a fight with your classmate in school. Who will you go to? Teacher, principal, parent, neighbor, or anyone else? In your class, there is a fight between your classmate. So, whom you will go? Teacher. Who will solve the problem? Teacher. So, these are the some situations, children, that who will solve the problem. So, we have specific problem for that specific person is there. Yes, for every problem, one person can't solve it. So there are the different persons who can solve certain problems, like in school, teacher or principal, at home, parents, or any other repairing work the specific person will do. So these are the some situations. Same thing we'll see on the board now. Okay, children?
Yes, children, I have written a table. We have already seen the some problems, right? Yes, who will solve the problems? I have drawn a table about if you have a problem at home, where you'll go. If you have a problem at school, where you'll go. We will see it. Okay, who do you go when you can't see the blackboard clearly? Where you'll go, ma? You'll go in school. You'll do, these are the problems in school. So you'll go to teacher, right? So when we can't see blackboard, it is a problem in where? At home or school? In school. And when you feel unwell, where you will go if you feel unwell at home? You'll go at home. It is a problem in the home. So you'll go to your mother and say, I'm not well. So that is a problem in home or school? Home. So whom do you go to when you want to buy a new tie? This is a home problem or a school problem? Home need or a school need? It is a home need. When you want to buy a new toy, you'll go to your mother or father, your parents. That is the home need. Whom would your class teacher go to if she wants more chairs and desk in the class? The teacher will go to principal if she need extra furniture for the class. So this is the problem in the school. If you are not having chairs in your classroom, you'll have a problem in home. You'll go to your mother and say, in our classroom there are no chairs and desks, no children. That is the problem in school. So the class teacher will go to the principal and ask, she'll ask the principal, we need extra furniture in our classroom. Okay, children, if you have any fight in your class, whom do you go? To your teacher. That is the problem in school. If you have any fight in your class with your friends, you'll go to your home and you'll say to your mother, no, children, it's not right. You have to solve then and there. You have to say your class teacher and inform her what is the problem, why the fight has been started. So we have to solve then and there in the class only. So that is the problem in the school. If you are hungry, I have already asked you this question. If you are hungry, you'll go to your neighbors or your class teacher and say, no, children, that is the problem and need in the home. So you'll go to your mother or your parents and ask when you are hungry. Okay, children, these are the solving problems at home and at school. So why do we need specific people to solve problems, children? Problems or specific needs? Why can't a problem in your class be solved by your parents? A parents can solve the problem. If you can't see the blackboard, your parents can solve the problem? No, children, your class teacher. So that she will say, sit in the front bench or nearby to the board, and she will say, okay, children. Or need at home taken care by the principal or your neighbor? In your home, if you want to buy a new tie, you'll come and say to your class teacher, your principal? No, children, your parents only. So there are the certain problems who can solve. Means there are the specific persons to solve the problem. These are the problems will solve at home only, that is your parents. And these are the problems solve at school only, that is your principal or your class teacher. So we go to a specific people for specific problems or needs. Our neighbors will not know how to solve a problem or take care of our needs like our parents would. Similarly, our parents will not be able to take care of something needed in our school. Only the school teacher or principal can find solution to problems in the school or meet certain needs. A family member will understand a problem and needs at home much better than a neighbor. Only family people can understand these problems. Only the teacher or principal can understand these problems or needs. Similarly, only the school teacher will understand the problems or needs of the school. Not the teachers of the other school or your parents will understand these problems. So there is a specific problems to solve with the specific people only, not by the other people. Okay, children, now I have small question for you. Do we always need someone else to help for us for everything? No, children. You can solve some problems by your own also. How? If your study table is untidy, you can clean it. Yes? So without anyone help, you can do it yourself, right? So if you want to drink a glass of water, you'll ask someone to get it. No, children, you will go in your kitchen and take some glass of water and you will drink. So some problems are not that the problems, those are not problems, there are the needs. So those are the needs, some needs are there, you can solve by yourself only. You can't depend upon other persons. So these are only the problems solved at home and these are the problems and needs solved at school. So this is about the solving problems. We have some small topic about this in your reader. Now everyone open your reader, page number 100.
Yes, children, did everyone open your reader, page number 100? Turn the page, children. You can see here block 16, that is new block, local governing bodies. Okay, we'll see the first topic here. Local governing bodies. Who take cares of you when you are hungry? Who take cares you when you are ill? Our family members, right? Like mother, father. Our family member take cares of us when we are hungry or when we are ill. When we have a problem in this class, we go to our teacher. All our problems can be solved by everyone. There are different people to solve different problems and take care of our needs. So there are the different persons to solve different problems or needs. So you can see here, we go to specific people for specific problems. If they have problem, they'll go to who will solve that problem, they'll go to there only. Okay, children. Now everyone open your work volume to workbook. Yes, children, everyone open page number 40. S1, solving problems. Write today's date, children, that is 16-11-2020. So, S1, solving problems. We'll see the first one. Who can take care of these needs and solve the problems? Fill the table. We have some problems. Who will help? And you have to write one way to solve the problem. First one. You are unable to do your homework. So, who will help? Your teacher will help to do the homework? No, your parents. Right? Write the parents. Mummy will show me how to do homework. Your mother will help you to do the homework. These are the some examples, children. Write your own answers, okay? You had a fight with your friend in school. Who will solve the problem in school means teacher. After writing this, draw like this only line, children, okay? Write neatly, okay? Take the pencil and eraser and take the scale also. Draw the line nicely and write neatly, children, okay? Who will solve the problem? Teacher. He or she will talk to both of us to know when we fought and help us to be friends again. So, teacher will solve the problems. The teacher will ask both what happened, why they were fought and help them to become again friends. Third one, you want to go for a holiday. Who will help you to go for a holiday? Who will help you? Parents. They will plan a holiday and buy tickets and take me. So they will plan a holiday and they will buy tickets and they will take you. Fourth one. You want to go for a class picnic. Class picnic, children, not holiday. So who will help you? Class teacher. He or her will take to the principal and get permission. So you want to go for a class picnic. So she will take to the principal about this topic and he or she will take the permission. You want to buy a storybook. Who will buy you a new thing? Storybooks? Parents. They will take me to the bookshop and buy a book for me. For me means for you. Your friend wants to visit the zoo. So, who's you'll ask? Friends and parents. Your friend want to visit the zoo. So, you'll ask the friend parents and your parents, okay? They will take her or him to the zoo. You don't like the food and you want to eat something else. Who you will ask? Mummy. She will give me something I like. Who will give you? Mummy will give you. Last one. Someone is troubling you in the school. Who will solve the problem? Who will help you? Teacher. My teacher will talk to the person troubling me. Who is troubling you? The teacher will talk to that person and solve the problem. So this is the first bit, children. Try to, you know the problems, who will solve, right? So try to read the question and write your own answer. These are the some examples, children, okay? But try to write your own answers. Next, do the second one. Write one thing you can do without taking anyone help. What problem or need you can solve without taking anyone help? I can make my own bed and pack my own bag for school. You can write anything. You can, I can clean my study table. Yes, I can set the dining table. You can write anything, children. Okay, that is your need or a problem. Not you can do some works without anyone help. So I can make my own bed and pack my own bag for school. This I gave you examples by try to write your own answers. Okay, now let's do the classwork. Okay, children, everyone, open your reader page number 103. Write these two, only two glossaries are there. Only write two keywords and then down only to the next to the two keywords, write these two glossaries and turn the page to 104. Copy down this bit and keep it, children. In the after the next classes, we'll do the answers, okay? But till that, you copy down these questions and keep it. Okay, children, complete your workbook S1 and write glossaries, keywords, and write these questions and keep it. In later classes, we'll do the answers, children. Okay, thank you.